How y'all doing this morning? This is Matt Wright. I'm one half of the nonprofit company Death, Dying, and Life Counseling Group, along with my best friend Jeremy Elliott. I'm sure you've seen him on this website too. That said, on the site, I wanted to start posting up videos, as well as in addition to the channeling sessions we put up and so forth, we're going to start putting videos of each, me and Jeremy, on the more personal side, talking about our past and how we came to this point in spirituality and life. Me, pretty much all my life, I've been kind of questioning what's going on, you know, for real. I don't trust what any church says, any minister, anything like that, for real. Not all the way. You know, I always examine evidence for myself. You should too. You have to use your intuition to tell you what's truth. I remember when I was a kid, I was probably about 8, 7 years old. First time I sat, I remember sitting in the church with my mom and my little brother, and I was listening to what the minister was having to say. And I was like, this is total bullshit. Not all of it, but a lot of it. You know, all the talk of hell and damnation and an angry God. I knew it was a bunch of shit, even at 7 years old. It was obvious, you know. Something told me there was something very wrong with the picture in the Bible. So, well, what I did is just kind of moved on from there. And just, you know, if the other things happened in my life, you know, just kind of tried to be as kind a person as I could be. You know, even before all of this stuff really got cranked up and started, you know, I was always about treating people with respect, treating people right, no matter what, no matter how they treated me. You know, because something told me that was the best way to do it. And I remember thinking, I was like, well, I'm just going to live my life doing a job I hate, you know, and just hope I can get by until I die. I remember thinking that, you know, a lot of times. I was like, well, I guess this so-called religion's good enough to believe in, and hopefully things will be all right. Find out what happens when I die. But I said another video, it was a couple of days after my paternal grandfather crossed over, and anyway, I was just sitting in a room meditating, and all of a sudden, I was looking at the wall, and what looked like a portal into another world shot out of it, and it was right in front of me. You know, I could see light and dark mixed together, left to right, and then with some kind of being in the clouds above it, like a vision or something. And I was like, is this God, or, you know, or have I gone nuts? And something told me, no, you haven't gone crazy, man. This is a message. And so anyway, I just kept looking into that portal, and it, you know, saw new things coming out of it. It's like a dimension into another world, the world of spirits, some kind of other dimension. I've seen all kinds of things in it, not just spirits, images, visions, other people in this dimension, like remote viewing them. When I stare at it, my astral body just kind of shoots out of my physical body and just glides towards it. And I can see that it's so-called silver cord link, that it's really a link you have to that dimension, you know, and that's there until you cross over and it's cut. But so I've seen that before, you know, just kind of floating out of my chest. Now, Sylvia Brown said in one of her books, I remember reading, that men are supposed to have those cords attached on their forehead and third eye around there, and women are supposed to have it around here on their chest. But shit, mine's attached to my chest. It makes sense, though, for me, because I think from my heart, not from my mind, as they say men usually do. You know, women think from their hearts, supposedly. So, who knows, you know? Who knows? It just makes sense to me. But, I don't know. You know, life just kept going on, you know? I kept understanding more and more stuff and meditations and stuff and experiencing different things. And believe me, my eyes were blown wide open. My mind was, too, to what's really going on. Yeah, I could just see so clearly, you know, what's really going on here. And all my life, I've always wanted to be someone special. All my life, I wanted to do something I love. You know, something I love doing, I want to help people. You know, I don't want to live some ordinary life. I mean, I just can't do that. I mean, I could have never just kept doing some job I hate for the rest of my life. You know, just trying to get by. Shit, that's what they want you to do. That's what government wants you to do. Business wants you to do that. You know, good little slaves, really. Slaves to the system. That's what they want. You know, I'm not going to give in to that. You have to do what you love. You have to look within and see where you're guided. So, that's what I've been doing. Me and Jeremy really work together as a team. I've known him since he was about 13 years old, and he's 30 now. He'll be 31 pretty soon, in a couple months. I'm in my mid-30s. Jeremy's always had an introspective into the spirit world. He's also a real good musician. You know? It's hard to really put some of this stuff into words. Oh, it really is. It really is. I like to go out like I'm doing now. I have to go walk my mom's dog. She's at her sister's house at Christmas, so I have to go take care of him. I can't have him in my place because I got a bunch of cats. That's not going to work. Anyway, all I really wanted and all I'm doing is to help others. That's all I really care about, is helping others understand life and death and dying and all that stuff. That's all I want. That's all I want. That's it. I want to be a force in this world. I don't want to be a force to be reckoned with. I want to be switching up things, tricking up the status quo, so to speak. Really, really changing shit up. You know? I think we're going to do that here. A lot of people don't have access or don't know about this kind of knowledge or don't know what to believe about it. Only thing I can say is just open your mind. You got to be open. If you're going to ask for a sign, you can do that. But you have to keep your mind open and you have to keep your eyes open and your ears open. And even your nose, because a sign could come in a lot of different ways. I've seen songs play on the radio at the exact moment I was thinking of something that described what I was thinking about. Smells appear in the room of the spirit and the cologne they always wore. Like my grandfather always smelled an aftershave when he's around the spirit. And he always wore one aftershave most of his life. You know, you just have to keep your mind open, though, for the sign. I wrote a little note to a dude who has a channel on YouTube named Brandon. I put this up on the blog, and you might want to read that about it. He was answering questions to some subscribers he has and whatnot about, do gay people go to hell? You know, and I told him, he asked about a sign, too, because he was wondering about what's really going on. And I said the same thing to him in the note. Open your mind. You know, open your mind and keep your eyes open. You know, because shit, even a stranger, a cashier at the grocery store, could say something to you that confirms your question, what you asked for the sign or whatever. You know, a stranger might smile at you